Hello and welcome to everybody. In this lecture I want to talk about the concept of compactness and a very important theorem in this context, namely the theorem of Arzela-Ascoli, which characterizes compactness in a very important situation. Compactness is a very important concept, and maybe let me give right away the definition. So I mean it's a property which is useful to have for sets. Okay, and we are looking in the context of Banach spaces. So X is a Banach space. We only consider it in this setting. And then we say that a subset of X is compact if, in a sense, it is small, so that it forces sequences to have at least convergent subsequences. So XK is compact if every sequence in K, so if I have a sequence of elements in K, if every sequence in K might not necessarily converge, but at least a subsequence has to converge. So every sequence in K has a subsequence which converges, and we also want that the limit is not just in X, but it should also belong to K, which converges to an element in K. Good, okay, so that's the definition. That's a very important property, and of course one would like to characterize maybe in more in other terms, when is a set compact? I mean, that's what we want to have of a set, but how do we decide whether it's compact? Okay, so let me make a few remarks. Maybe the first remark is that this here is what is usually called sequentially compact, and maybe in a more general situation of topological spaces, there is a definition of compactness which is via covers by open sets. Okay, so namely compactness in general is defined by the property that every open cover of my set has a finite subcover. Okay, in the Banach space setting or the setting of norm spaces, this is equivalent to sequentially compact. So what I define here as compact. Okay, so maybe the first remark, this compact here is equivalent in our Banach space setting to the property that every open cover of K, so if I have any collection of open sets which cover the set K, then this has a finite subcover. So then actually I only need finitely many of those sets to cover K, has a finite subcover. Okay, that's also very useful characterization, but we will stick with the sequential compactness, which in this setting is equivalent. So we don't have to bother about this. Good. Okay, and then maybe now let's go in the direction of, yeah, what does it really mean or for a set to be compact, or what are properties which allow us to decide whether a set is compact. And so maybe one should first think about what does it mean if a set is compact? Are there easy consequences of this? And it's very easy to see that a set which is compact is of course closed. So in general, if K is compact, then this implies that K is closed. I mean that's the property that the limit of the subsequence should belong to K. Okay, so because I mean, what does it mean? Maybe to see this, so assume K is not closed. Just to see this, so if, let us assume it's not closed, and then we should see it's not compact. So K is not closed. Okay, and closed means whenever I have a convergent sequence, then the limit should belong to the set. So if it is not closed, this means there exists a sequence which converges, but the limit is not in K. Okay, so K not closed. So this means there exists a sequence of elements xn such that all the elements in the sequence belong to K. And the sequence converges xn converges to an element, but the limit does not belong. Does not belong to K. Good. Okay, but then let us look on this sequence from the point of view of the notion of compactness. So here I have a sequence. So compactness tells us that there exists a subsequence which converges to an element in K. Okay, but I mean the whole sequence converges which to X, which means every subsequence, of course, also converges to this X, but this X is not in K. So there is no subsequence which can converge to something in K. Okay, so this means so every subsequence necessarily also converges to this element X, but this belongs not to K. So this means my set cannot be compact. K is not compact. Okay, so if K is not closed, it's not compact, or the other way around, if my set is compact, it must be closed. Okay, so that's one property which compact sets always have. And then another property which is easy to see is that it must be bounded. Okay. So and this is more in the idea that my set should be small so that it forces things a subsequence to converge and bound if it's unbounded, then the set is just too big and I have many possibilities to avoid this property of compactness. Okay, so if K is compact, then it also must be bounded. And bounded, of course, in norm. So this means there exists, let's say, a constant m bigger than 0, so that the norm of all elements in K are at most m, such that the norm of x is less or equal m for all x in my set K. Okay, and this is, again, easy to see. Again, do it by contraposition. So assume my set is not bounded. So this means I cannot bound the norm of the elements in my set. And this means I'm finding elements in my set where the norm is getting bigger and bigger. So this means I'm finding a sequence where the norm goes to infinity. Yeah, it's not bounded. So this means there exists a sequence xn. Of course, the xn's are in my set, but I cannot bound their norm, which means the sequence of the norms of those guys goes to infinity, such that the norm of xn goes to infinity. Okay, now we have a sequence, so we can look from the point of view of compactness. So if my set would be compact, then this sequence must have a convergent subsequence. So if K is compact, so this is a sequence in K, then this would say that there exists a convergent subsequence. So a subsequence, so I'm running only over some of the n's, and if K goes to infinity, this converges to something. Okay, this something is in K, but actually in here it doesn't matter. Yeah, we are not so much interested in this, but the point is that if this converges to X, then this means that the norms of the X and K have to converge to the norm of X, because taking the norm is continuous in a Banach space or in a normed space. Okay. But on the other hand, X and K is a subsequence of the original sequence for which the norm goes to infinity. So also for this subsequence, the norm has to go to infinity. So this here converges to infinity on one hand, but on the other hand, it must also converge to a finite number. Of course, the norm of X is finite. And this is a contradiction, which tells me that K cannot be compact. So K is not compact. Okay, so if K is not bounded, it cannot be compact, or the other way around, if K is compact, it must be bounded. Good, okay, so here we have two properties which we should check if we want to see whether a set is compact. Namely, we should better check that it is bounded and closed, because otherwise it has no chance of being compact. Good, okay. And now the question, of course, is, I mean, is this enough? because I mean, this would be nice. I mean, closed and bounded are things which usually are easy to check. Okay, bounded compactness to check by the definition. That's not clear how we should do this. So we should have other properties which tell us that a set is compact. Okay, and actually, in a finite dimensional case, if our Banach space is finite dimensional, then those two properties are actually enough. Okay, and that's the famous theorem of Heine-Borel. In finite dimensions, it's really compactness is exactly the same as being closed and bounded. And thus, it's an easy property to check. Okay, so the finite dimensional situation is indeed easy. So for finite dimensional Banach spaces or normed spaces, we really have that the set K is compact if and only if K is closed and bounded. And that's the famous Heine-Borel theorem. And of course, the main ingredient in proving this is the Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem, which tells us that in R, a bounded sequence has a convergent subsequence. That's of course exactly what compactness is about. So in principle, in finite dimensions, we go back to R, because finite dimensions is just a finite collection of copies of R. And for each copy of R, we have the Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem, which tells us that a bounded sequence has a convergent subsequence, which is this idea that if you have a sequence in interval, then you cut the interval into two, and then you find still infinitely many elements of the sequence in one of the two halves, and you continue like this, and in the end, you can construct a subsequence which has to converge. Okay, so this is Heine-Borel, and the main ingredient is Bolzano-Weierstrass. Okay, so that's the things which usually you do in the analysis or real analysis class. Good, okay, but of course, I mean, our main Banach spaces, the Banach spaces we are interested in, are usually infinite dimensional. And then the situation is not so easy, but it's also more interesting. Okay, so in infinite dimensions, this is not true anymore. Compactness, of course, means always it's closed and bounded, but it's not the other way around. To check that it's closed and bounded is not enough in infinite dimensions to get that you have a compact set. So in infinite dimensions, in infinite dimensional Banach spaces, this is not true. It's actually, I mean, that this is true is actually a characterization of a finite dimensional situation. Okay, so it's not true anymore. So compactness is more than just being closed and bounded. And so in particular, this means that the unit ball, I mean, the closed unit ball in a Banach space, this is a closed set, and it's bounded. And in finite dimensions, this is compact. So in a sense, the unit ball in finite dimensions is somehow small. You don't have enough space to enforce that if you have a sequence, that the elements from the sequence all stay away from each other. So they must cluster somewhere. They have a convergent subsequence. If you are in infinite dimensions, then actually, I mean, in each dimension, you are bounded. Okay, so you cannot stay away from each other in a dimension, in a fixed dimension, but I mean, you have infinitely many dimensions in which you can go, and then you can really make sure that the elements stay away from each other. Okay, so there are infinitely many dimensions enough to allow this. Good, okay, so this is not true anymore. So compactness is more than just closed and bounded. Okay, and of course it would be good to have concrete criteria what this more is. And of course, in general, it's hard to say what this really means, what this more is, at least in concrete terms. But at least for a very important Banach space, namely the space of continuous functions, we have a very precise characterization of this. And this is exactly this theorem of Arzela-Ascoli. Okay, so now we will go in a direction of not talking about general Banach spaces anymore, but look on the continuous functions on a compact set, let's say the interval 0, 1, and try to understand what compactness means in this context.